Creon, sea bass, broil, dry, oregano, basil, steamed vegetables.
So, Angelo, how do I look?
I look good. Too thin, maybe.
Can't be too thin today, Angelo. It's the kind of world we're living in. You know why spit don't stick to me? I'm thin, I'm fit, I'm clean. I look like the president of U.S. Steel. It's the 90s, Angelo. I respect you more than I do my mother and the Pope. But you walk into court with a roll around your middle, grease hanging off your chin. It's an image that hurts us, Angelo. It makes us look like cartoons.
Cartoons. Well, on Saturday morning TV, I start to worry.
Angelo.
I never walked in court with grease on my chin.
I just don't want the feds in their $40 suits feeling too confident.
They're sweating. They're sweating in them suits, Colin. You know why? Because they got nothing. I gotta go. I got some work at the office.
Which office?
Across the street. Maybe next time.
You give me a place with a kitchen?
All the fettuccine and South Peach you can eat.
Manny, you be nice to me, I'll be nice to you, Mancuso. You got the biggest fish in the sea here. I'm gonna bring Carlo Brozzi to his knees.
Protection, you got it. You wanted some time, you got that too. You need some answers. Give me a break, will you? Them names and dates confuse me. I remember anything, you'll be the first to know.
Angelo, we didn't set this thing up for you to roll over on the installment plan. Come on, do the right thing. Gary.
Want to build a RICO case against Carlo Brozzi?
Want to know how we put the Baltimore docks in his pockets? I can tell you all about that. Bribery, extortion, murder. Relax. I mean, relax. Let me get used to the surroundings here.
It beats getting used to the exercise yard in Marion. Who's murder?
Trouble with you, Fred. You got no patience.
Then you got no deal unless I eat on a few bars. Who's murder?
Mickey Fitzmaurice. You ever heard of him?
Yeah, sure. The union boss. Makes Jimmy Hoffa look like a lightweight.
6 years, you civil servant's been banging your head against the wall on that one. Right, Mancuso? The guy that cracks that one gets the Congressional Medal of Honor.
Who ordered the hit on Fitzmaurice?
Did I say anybody give an order?
Carlo Brazzi never made a move without you knowing about it.
Okay. I notice. Brazzi needed Fitzmaurice dead. He wanted him dead. Whether he ordered him dead? Maybe you should talk to Frank Gulliman.
Who's that?
Fitzmaurice, Lieutenant Treasurer of the Union, an old commie. A Mick and a commie, what a combo. He knows things. He don't talk, but he knows things.
Yeah, like you.
Look. I come out on one condition. Federal protection for me and the person closest to me.
Angelo, believe me, as soon as I get what I need, we're going to make contact with your wife.
Hey, I didn't tell you this when we cut the deal because I didn't think you'd go for it.
What's that?
That ain't my wife. Hey, you know how it is. I was tired of the life. I'm getting old. Things were moving too fast for me. Carlo Brazzi brought in the babagna, the heroin. We didn't touch that stuff when I was coming up. I took an oath not to touch that stuff. Wanted out. Met somebody. Made me want it even more. Vinny Carlozzi. He's a good kid.
Yeah. I know, guys like us ain't supposed to be like that.
Look. If I testify against Carlo Brazzi, Brazzi will find out about it and he'll whack Vinny. I want that boy under protection. When I get your word on that, I'll tell you how Carlo Brazzi raped the Baltimore docks.
Vinny Carlozzi. Oh, come on. Love is blind. Am I running a center for deviance around here? How am I supposed to go upstairs and ask for a protection budget for a mafioso with a gay lover?
No boyfriend. No talk from Fat Angelo.
Then we're just going to have to cut this guy loose.
Are you kidding me? We're in the information business. You throw a guy like Fat Angelo back in the street, nobody's ever going to talk to an agent.
Okay, you got 72 hours. If he doesn't produce, he is out of the program.
When I was coming up, I was taught that a witness is your baby. No matter what he did before, if he's in your hands, you treat him like glass. That's how I run my show.
This isn't your show?
Why, tell it isn't. I was on this case 18 months before you even got here. Besides, Fat Angelo might tell us who clipped Mickey Fitzmaurice.
Mickey Fitzmaurice?
Right.
Oh, Mancuso, a lot of smart cops have stubbed their toe on that one.
What?
We'll talk about this later.
Can't wait for your manicure. I gotta know what to tell Fat Angelo right now.
Just pump the guy. Get me something that I can dangle under the SAC's nose. And then maybe we'll talk about the boyfriend. Now you got 72 hours to set your watch. Miss Simmons?
Just call me Tony.
Oh, it's a pleasure to meet you, Tony.
Heard you were on the move. They didn't tell me you look like a movie star. Yes, I gave you a file.
Jane,
mm-hmm.
Who's the look of rubbing elbows with Masters?
Tony Simmons.
Who?
You know, the Washingtonian, Vanity Fair, Vogue, photographer?
No.
Come on, you had to have heard of her.
No, I forgot to renew my subscription to Vogue. I never got around to it.
Yeah, well, you're nobody famous unless she's photographed you. What do you suppose she wants with him?
So, why me? I don't run a country.
Not yet. But I hear you're on an express elevator to the top. My assignment was to find 10 men, all young, all blue flamers. 10 young Washingtonians most likely to succeed.
What happens if your 10 best fizzle out?
They won't. I pick winners and men like other people pick horses.
Would have loved to have heard what you said to Gaddafi.
Read my memoirs. You're a new kid on the block, aren't you?
Well, I've been around a couple of months.
Born and raised in Wisconsin. All-state wrestling team. Full scholarship to Dartmouth.
You do your homework.
I try. How long since you've been to a really good party?
Oh, well, unless you count the Bureau's 4th of July cookout as a party.
I'd like to show you off. My latest find.
Show me off? To whom?
The kind of people who like to be on an elevator when it starts to rise. Besides, I'll get a chance to study you. It'll make a prettier picture in the end.
You make a pretty picture.
One thing about men on the move. Always in a hurry.
Comfort us with the great power of your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. May you rest in peace. Amen. He was a loving husband to Carmela de Paula, a brother to us all, a man of peace, conciliation, wisdom, heart. Please salute Sir Angelo.
Touching.
Yeah, everybody loves a good cry. Grieving widow. Both of them. Get a good shot. I want to show Angela how much he's going to be missed.
Read lips?
Probably comforting each other in their hour of need.
I'm depressed. My stomach's in knots. Angelo de Paula was my friend. Angelo de Paula had a weakness. Weak man's.
There's bad things. What that scum did to me. Crawling on his belly to the feds. That was a bad thing. Benny, if I were you, I would look real sad. Like I was in mourning. Because you are. After all, Angelo de Paula's a dead man.
How'd you like your debut?
Scary. Washington women fight.
Hey, you were a hit. 3 senators' wives and a lady lobbyist all asked for a phone number.
Did you give it to them?
Of course not. You're selfish. Nightcap?
Bye, man.
Photograph of the King Chris Chef in Life magazine.
No.
He had on this big old fur coat. Most men would have looked pretty similar to the coat, right? Yeah. Chris Chef didn't. You could almost touch the power. I was 10 the first time I saw that photograph. I felt like something electric was running up and down my spine. That was the first time I ever looked into a man's face and didn't feel sorry for him.
Is that how you became Tony Simmons?
That and a lot of hard work. Who do you want to be?
Will you?
Tell me.
Elliot Ness.
That Ness never had any fun.
Maybe, but he was really something special.
You're thinking of Kevin Costner.
Will the one I love be coming back to me? Will the one I love be coming back?
I always wonder what a blue flame is like.
What is it like?
Hot. And if it touches you, it burns you. There's nothing left.
Frank Gulliver?
Yeah.
Max Hughes, FBI.
A Fed on the docks, huh? It's like a snowball in a microwave. Feds and unions don't hardly mix.
How do you figure?
You remember back in 56 when we were on lockout, your boys, they came marching in with the Pinkertons and started with the nightsticks on our heads?
You know Mickey Fitzmaurice back then?
Yeah, sure. We used to walk down 14th Street together. Women would be hanging out of the windows, throwing their keys down at him. He was that handsome.
What happened to him?
I don't know. Mickey made his enemies. Any guy that smart and that honest makes enemies down here. He wasn't right for this world. Everything's mixed up now, and he was simple, not stupid. A straight-on guy.
That's what people say about you.
Me? Mickey was captain of the team. I was second string.
When was the last time you saw Mickey Fitzmaurice?
Come on. Territory's all been covered. Why do you want to rake it up again?
Because it needs raking.
The day Mickey disappeared, I was out fishing. I like to fish.
Sure.
You see those hooks down there by the loading platform? I'd like to take the guy who got Mickey and hang him from one of those hooks like a slab of meat. Look, I could buy you a beer, and I could tell you war stories, that's all. Now I got a union to run, Mancuso. I wish I could help, but I can't.
He's working right now.
Soon. I promise. I gotta go.
Well, how was that?
Vinny. I had to talk to him, Mancuso. I missed the kid.
Carlo Bracci talks to him, too. Very friendly at your funeral.
I don't believe that.
You better believe it. Come on, let's get out of here.
Come on, Angelo, move in.
Check us out.
Where are you going?
Some place where Bracci can't find him.
Took your advice, saw Frank Gulliver. Said Fitzmaurice could have been a pinup boy for the Salvation Army.
What do you mean? Bracci got that Union hack right in his pocket.
Doesn't add up. Gulliver's a bright shade of red. Bracci's favorite color is golden green.
Yeah. Gulliver knows. Just keep working on him.
Can't keep working on him. Supposed to be working on you. Check the records at the Eden Rock Spa. Bracci's washing machine. Gulliver's got his dirty paw prints all over the place. Where are we going? Find out when you get there.
Mancuso, you gotta let me talk to Vinny. Haven't you ever been in love?
What are you, Bob Hope? Is this a joke or what?
The guy who runs this place is an old pal of mine. He's retired FBI. He used to be on J. Edgar Hoover's personal staff. And no pillow talk around here. The only phone is in the office, and that is locked.
Peace be with you.
How long has it been since your last confession?
35 years, but who's counting?
Somebody is. What's up, Mac? Who's up?
Father, I could use your help. I need some legwork.
Yeah, sure.
You check the records of the Eden Rock Spa in Chesapeake Bay.
Looking for what?
Frank Gulliver.
Anything you say.
Great interplay of light and dark, don't you think?
That's Jesse Helms. A moonfrat Angelo.
Huh? What?
Instinct. The hotel was safe enough.
Hope it's worth it, Mancuso, because I have serious doubts about how valuable Angelo DiPaolo is to this case. And the SAC pulled me in this morning. Justice is skeptical. It's just the whole thing. The mafia, Brazzi, spaghetti twirling Goombas. It just feels like old news to me. Now, terrorism. Mancuso, that is the crime of the 90s. People like the PLO and Red October, they make the Carlo Brazzis of this world look like Eagle Scouts.
Brazzi is a sociopath. He's a killer, an extortionist. He's strangling the union.
Read the Washington Post, Mancuso. The unions are on their way out. It's all mine. I'm late.
As long as Brazzi owns the docks, he can shove anything he wants through there. Heroin, cocaine, guns, anything.
Here. What's that?
D'Angelo's new address. You, me, and the priest. The only ones who know.
You really do have a medieval mind, don't you, Mancuso?
I'm giving you your face for the very first time. Most people think they know what they look like. They don't. They need someone to show them. See? Yes? Can't talk. Gotta get this fixer off my fingers. Took your time getting here.
I didn't know I was expecting.
You have to go back.
So work today.
Call your secretary. Tell her you're getting lost.
That's it. No more. That's it. Have I told you how I feel about you?
No.
Do you want to know?
I'm not sure.
I think I love you. See what I said? I love you. Give me that.
Hey, don't!
Now, time to turn the tables here. Beautiful. Beautiful. The curve of your ankle. Very nice. The calf, good. And the hollow behind your knee and the thigh. It's very nice. Beautiful.
Rumors that there is trouble in the Brazzi family after the execution murder of underboss Fat Angelo DiPaolo. DiPaolo was thought to be the muscle behind the stylish Brazzi. Sources tell us Brazzi's flamboyant. They have ruffled a few feathers.
Love to photograph him. Brute force in a silk suit. What a study.
I'm making a case against him.
Must feel like David taking on Goliath.
Yes, David's gonna take Goliath down, too.
With what?
Second coming Fat Angelo DiPaolo.
What do you mean? He's alive? Take me to him.
What?
Fat Angelo. Take me to him. Blindfold me. Take me in the dead of night. I don't care. I just want to photograph him.
You can't.
Oh, Eddie. I want to capture a look of terror in his eyes.
I can't.
Eddie, please. Take me. I want to see. I just want to see. Eddie, I'm a watcher.
Good morning, peace of the Lord.
And that was when Louis Gamboni iced Jimmy DeWeese on the Meadowlands. Brings us to 75. What was Carlo Brazzi doing in 1975? Lenny, what were you doing in 75? Slow year. Yeah. Things were simple then. Take the dog for a walk without getting mugged. Park the car in your driveway, still be there in the morning.
Yeah, but your line of work, it's somebody to start the car for you.
Come on, Mancuso. We ain't that different. Where you from?
New York, Florida side.
Yeah, me too. See? You knew guys like me when you were coming up.
Could have been like you, but the other way.
You know, what'd I tell you? The only difference between us, twist of fate. Hey, come on, be a good guy, will you? Go outside, get me a calzone.
Angelo, there is no outside. There's just you, me, and the priest.
I'm hungry.
See what they got in the kitchen.
The body of Christ.
The blood of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The blood of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The blood of Christ.
The body of Christ.
These are for you.
Oh, thank you.
Yes?
I left messages all over. You never got back to me.
What's the problem?
Fat Angelo's dead.
What? How?
His boyfriend did it. He got popped for it. I don't know how it happened. I never lost a witness before. Turning it over inside out. Me and Fat Angelo, flip sides of the same coin. When we grew up, either became a cop, a crook, or a priest. I sort of liked the guy.
This is terrific. Fat Angelo sleeps with the fishes, and your investigation's in the point.
You, me, and the priest were the only ones who knew where he was.
Yeah.
So?
Talk to the priest.
What?
Tony Simmons for you, line 3.
Tell her I'm not in. Is there anything else?
Gene.
Hmm?
Yeah, I gotta talk to you. How well do you know McMaster's secretary?
Share an occasional yogurt over lunch.
The key to his office. You gotta get it from her.
Yes.
When I was starting out, the ASAC was second man to God. You trusted him before you trusted yourself. I gotta see McMaster's appointment book. The record of all his phone calls for the past 48 hours.
Nick, do you know what you're doing?
I know.
I'll try.
Yeah, good. Hi.
Where are you? Been looking everywhere for you. Everybody's worried about you.
I'm all right.
Well, I got something here that might cheer you up. I just spent the last hour talking about the Eden Rock Spa with a friend working fraud at Justice. Buy me lunch?
The Eden Rock Spa. Heart-shaped beds, diet lunches, sunken bathtubs, and very Brazzi money.
So, it's one of Carlo Brazzi's laundering operations.
Yeah, except for one detail. The names of the principal stockholders in the company that built it. Only one you never heard of before is Julia Jean Paterno.
Who's that?
Mrs. Frank Gulliver. She used to be Fitzmaurice's secretary. Gulliver used her as a front. And there's more. Guess where the money to build the spa came from? About 5,000 members of the dock workers' union. Unbeknownst to themselves, they loaned Carlo Brazzi $4.5 million out of their pension. Hate to be around when they try to retire.
Frank Gulliver signed the loan.
You got it. Another loan, too. Spas, shopping malls, restaurants. Carlo Brazzi gets fat and the union kitty dwindles. Another blow to American labor.
Doesn't matter what you got here. Brazzi case is a dead dog.
I can get show cause subpoenas by 3 o'clock. Maybe Gulliver will be there. It's your choice. You talk to us, or you talk to the grand jury.
About what?
About the relationship between Carlo Brazzi and Eddie Fitzmaurice.
You know, when I was a kid, I had to work the docks to feed the family. 13 brothers and sisters. Ain't that a kick? The docks could work, but I didn't complain. Fell in love with the sea air.
It's clean. So are you. What happened?
People like you tried to crush this union before. I don't make deals with people like you.
No. You do worse. You steal dreams. You skim off the top of the rank and file when you should be protecting them. The union is some people's last defense. Ever since you hooked up with Carlo Brazzi, you've been knocking it apart, piece by piece. Now, either you make this deal, or you're going to go down hard.
I grew up dreaming of one big union. Those words, they were magic in my ears. You weren't there, Nick Cuso. You didn't lose sleep for the union, and you didn't lose blood for the union. You two got anything else to say to me? You say it to my lawyer.
Thank you.
Hey, you hiding out?
What's up?
Oh, I need your John Hancock. Warrant request for Francis X. Gulliver. Esquire. Want to talk about it?
Why? I signed.
I mean, what's eating you up?
Hell no. I don't have a care in the world.
Oh, yeah. I can see that. So, what's the bitch? Too much starch in your shirt?
Women.
Oh. Girl trouble? Fall in love at the prom?
Something like that.
Well, give it time. Wouldn't open any joint banking account just yet.
Big help. More complicated than that. I fell into something.
Hey, Eddie, I'm listening.
Forget it.
leg there.
Sorry, wish I could help you.
Thanks.
Hope it worked out.
To the day your picture will be in here to love Tony. McMaster's idea of a stroke book. Who do you talk to after me? Who do you see?
Her.
What?
Just her. After you talked to him, he went to lunch with her. There's a note in the phone pad where it could be reached in case of emergency. It's her number.
Call records and surveillance. Get everything we've got on Tony Simmons. And all the wiretaps on Bratson. Everything we've got.
Yes.
Crazy.
What's that?
They rent on an apartment. Might as well just move in here.
Plenty of room for two at my place.
Yes. You want some coffee?
Pass. Hey.
What? You find something?
Look at this.
How bad do you want to nail McMaster's? Because if you do, you just hit the jackpot.
Say what you gotta say.
She made a mark as a second string camera on the Baltimore Sun. She did a photo essay on the docks. Met Bratzy, and he was a rocket on the rise. She figured up was better than down.
It is. What else?
A couple of Pulitzer Prize nominations, magazine covers. Go there. Read yourself.
You know, I'm almost relieved. I knew someday I was gonna run into a wall. I've been running from it my whole life. It was out there waiting for me. I just didn't know it had such a beautiful face. What am I going to do?
Talk to the man on the sixth floor.
Talk to him, I'm out. You know, you could burn me with this.
Yeah, I guess.
So why don't you?
I had a partner. He got involved with the wrong woman on a case. It cost him his life. You're lucky. You're still here. We're going to nail Carlo Bratzy.
Huh?
By getting Tony Simmons to talk.
Give me a few minutes alone with her first.
Yes.
that, Tony? Going somewhere?
Yeah, assignment. Covering a role divorce in England. I wish you were coming with me.
Yeah. I got something to ask you.
I'm listening.
Who pays for this place? Carlo Brazzi?
I pay my own way. Some people have talent, Eddie. Others just have jobs.
Look, Tony, I know that you fed him Fat Angelo's address. And that makes you an accessory to murder.
Let go.
Why? Why Brazzi, Tony? What is he to you? Why?
I said let
Why?
Go!
Why? Damn it!
You wouldn't understand.
Try me.
It's a little over your head, Eddie. Sex. Real sex. Another word for power. Are you arresting me? Let me finish getting dressed.
Insurance, in case Brazzi dropped you, you should have dumped these a long time ago. Accessory to murder.
They were important to me. First time I ever photographed a dying man.
You know who this is?
Mickey Fitzmaurice.
Fitzmaurice. His best friend, Frank Oliver.
Is this your idea, Kicks?
Carlo wanted to test how tough I was, so he took me along. He got so high on stuff like that. That's how it was with me and him. Some people like their liquor straight. We were a crazy cocktail.
Yeah. Happy hour's over.
Eddie. How sweet. Didn't know you had the imagination.
I figure we could break ground on the new hall in a week, as soon as we get full membership approval.
Hey, Frank.
I told you, you're not welcome around here, Mancuso.
Pack it back, Frank.
Where am I going?
Upriver with Carlo Brazzi and his girlfriend.
What are you talking about?
Great moments in American history. Mickey Fitzmaurice dies. The rest of the union goes down with him. Here, have a look.
There you go. Hey, let me have one of those.
Here you are. What'd you do, Frank? Invite him out for a beer, then drive him over to Carlo Brazzi?
That's a lie! Give me that. Look, I had nothing to do with the killing.
You set him up, Frank.
No, I didn't! Brazzi's men have been after me for a long time, trying to cause a rift between me and Mickey. The day Missy died, I was out fishing. When I got home, one of Brazzi's goons was waiting for me with a shotgun. I told him what he could do with it, and that made him mad. When I came to, I was in the marshes outside town. They already dug a hole for Missy. I knew it was him. Even with the hood on, I knew the build. The star in his right hand from the Pinkerton Club. There was some girl taking pictures like it was a movie. Brazzi said, your choice, Gulliver. Bring the union over to me or get into the hole with him. Look, I didn't want to die. I didn't want to die that way. Hey, what was I supposed to do anyway?
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you.
I'm not lying. I know, but I don't know what.
Hey, how'd it go with the SAC?
Under a censure. Would have been a lot worse if the lab boys hadn't found this in Tony's loft. Do you remember writing that?
Church address. Must have gotten that out of your pants. You did the right thing talking to the SAC.
He wants to elevate you to the position of sainthood.
Not dead yet.
Listen, Mancuso, I don't know what to say. I feel really ashamed about this whole thing. I just
got the first one. You're in a hurry.
Yeah, but I should have put it together.
Start to think with your hormones doing cartwheels. Forget it. We all learn from Oscar's kid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Saturday's a sporting kind of day on NBC. In the afternoon, it's the fall PBA Tour. Pin-to-pin action from some of America's top bowlers in the Toyota Classic. Plus, final round coverage of the Isuzu Kapalua International Golf Tournament on NBC Sports. Then, Saturday Night Live, Sports and All, new show.
Hi, I'm Chris Evert. Now that I've retired from tennis, I can finally do all the things other normal happily married women do, like hosting Saturday Night Live with Eurythmics.